Hi guys, welcome back, and we're now looking at dominant 9, okay? So this is, if you remember when we did the 7th chords, if you've been through that section, then we talked about the fact that the 7th chord is constructed by taking the 1, 3, 5 and the flat 7. That gives you a dominant 7th chord, okay? Now, here, we're looking to extend that further. So now this whole family of dominant chords can be extended and we can make a dominant 9th chord, okay? So what I'm gonna do here is we're just gonna write out dominant 9th, okay? So I'm just gonna write out dominant. This is why you would never typically write that. And remind ourselves that probably this would be simply written as a 9. Okay, so nothing apart from the letter and the 9, that's all you're gonna see. Just like with the dominant 7s, if you remember, it was just A7 or B7 or C7. Okay, just that. Okay, so that's how you would write it out. Now, let's have a look at the chord construction itself. Okay, so with the dominant 9th chord, sorry, I wrote 7th there, I meant 9th. With the dominant 9th chord, we're gonna have the root, the 3rd, and the 5th. And then the flat 7, okay? And then, at that point, we're gonna add the 9, okay? So again, let's just break that down, shall we? So we've got this kind of major element of it here. We've got this root, 3rd, and 5th, which is a major chord. Basically, this major 3rd here, this natural 3rd, really, you know, defines that major sound, okay? Now, when we look at flat 7, that is the part that we add to the major chord to make dominant, okay? Before we had the opportunity to add sevenths, dominant chords just didn't exist in triad form, okay? You have to have this kind of duel, this conversation between the major third and the flat seventh. If you don't have that, it's not a dominant chord, okay? So obviously, when you see dominant, that is what you see. That's what you are referring to, basically. Then, of course, right at the end, you're adding the 9, okay? And again, it's just an instruction to add the 9th, which is, of course, the 2 up an octave, okay? So when you put all that together, you can see, you know, it's just one note difference from a C major 9, but that note makes all the difference, believe me. So let's write it out. So we're going to do a C 9, so C dominant 9. That's how it would be written kind of shorthand. And it would simply be C, E, G, that's your 1, 3, 5. Then we'd have a B flat, which is the flat 7, and then the D, okay? So what I want you guys to do, again, is go to the guitar and try and put those 5 notes on the guitar somewhere, okay? If you already know how to play a C dominant 7th chord, then just take the C dominant 7th, which is those 4 notes, and add the D, okay? And again, just like we talked about with the minor 9th and the major 9th, this note should try and be high up in the chord. So you can really hear it as this, as the melody note, okay? Now, the cool thing about the 9th chord, the dominant 9th chord, is especially in blues music and funk music, the kind of default go-to chord quite a lot of the time for guitarists is the 9 rather than the 7, okay? I couldn't tell you exactly why, it just seems to have just happened, and I think it's a slightly nicer sounding chord for that style of music, okay? So if you're watching Stevie Ray Vaughan play or Eric Clapton or, you know, anyone like that in the blues world, then they're probably going and playing 9th chords, especially on the 4 and the 5 in a blues, okay? It's just very, very normal. So these are really common. In fact, all of these are really common, but this one specifically in blues music is super common, and funk as well. So, guys, you've got all of this now, okay? And to summarize in the last lesson, what we're gonna be doing is talking about realistically starting to use this stuff in everyday guitar playing,